Hey guys, this is the follow-up to the first video where I passed through the Salt Mountain Range going uphill. This is a mountain range located in Pakistan where we have the second largest salt mine in the world. Here I am returning back going downhill. For whatever reason, there was no audio on the original footage, so I'm doing a voiceover. Also, apologies for the sun glare through the windscreen. I haven't made these type of videos before, so we'll look into it how to do it better next time. When going downhill, your braking system is key to ensure a safe drive down. Before any road trip, you should get your brakes and overall the condition of your vehicle checked, tires included. Here, the speed limit is at 60 kilometers per hour. Certain points, it is at 40. Whenever driving downhill for a long duration, you should not ride your brakes, where you are constantly pressing the brake pedal in order to maintain a safe speed or keep it at the speed limit. Also, because I've seen this before, never ever put your vehicle in neutral gear while going down. When you are constantly on your brake pedal, your brakes will heat up. There's a term called brake fade. When your brakes heat to a certain point, it can temporarily lose braking power. So obviously, going downhill, loss of brake power, not a good situation to be in. If you start to smell something burning, immediately but safely pull over to the side. Disc brakes are more resistant to brake fade due to its open design. Heat dissipates quicker. For drum brakes, it being a closed design, it's more prone to it. On smaller vehicles, like smaller Hondas, for example, they do have drums in the rear. You will find emergency ramps on highways, especially in steep areas. If you feel that you have lost your brakes, this is your best bet at stopping. Pull over into this ramp. As your vehicle comes to a stop, put the handbrake or e-brake on. You don't want to roll back now. If that also doesn't work, you have a manual, put it in first gear and shut the engine off. If you have an auto, put your car in park mode, P mode. As an added measure of safety in this particular example, move your steering wheel all the way to the left. So in case you are rolling back, you will back up into the sidewall. Here you can see the coolant is at 80 degrees Celsius compared to 88 when I was going uphill, so less stress on the cooling system. So when going downhill, you should do engine braking, where you lift your foot off the acceleration to slow down in combination with choosing a lower gear or gear ratio. How engine braking occurs does differ from petrol to diesel engines. The end goal is the same. Here I am driving a manual where I alternate between the second and third gear. Of course, you should know your gear ratios. So for example, if you're going at 60 kilometers an hour, you should not put it into first gear. You can cause transmission and engine damage. As you can see on the screen, just by using an appropriate gear, I did not have to use the brakes continuously. In fact, I didn't use much at all while maintaining my speed. In traditional automatic cars, downshift to say 3 or 2, depending on the situation. Other gearboxes like CVTs, for example, use S or L mode, or manually select your gear or lock in your gear ratio. There's no need to stay near the max end of the RPM range. Somewhere in the middle is good enough. The goal here is to assist in braking, not to prevent using the brakes at all. Here I shifted back into second gear and I was able to maintain my speed easily without any acceleration and without using any brakes. While the main goal of using engine braking and using the appropriate gear is to assist you in having a safe drive, it has an added benefit of less wear on your brake pads. As always, thanks for watching.